guess my question is whether you and Mr. Kramer had any discussion about James Damiano in this at lunch.
No, just that I don't really know Jim about the studio. Nothing.
And did he discuss anything about any of the claims or facts or issues involved in this case, as you understand?
No, not that we already know about or talked about.
Well, what did you talk about with Mr. Kramer at lunch concerning this case?
Concerning this case, there wasn't much talked about.
Was anything talked about?
I met Jim in the studio, and I really have no involvement in this. There's nothing really concrete that I have that's going to be, as we talked at my house, too, same thing. I mean, I still to this day wonder why I'm here, because I met Jim Damiano twice in the studio. It shows up my store, and here I am. You know, I don't even recall his music. I never hung out with him personally. The only thing that I know is about this thing with Tony Tiller, which I don't know if he got in tickets or not, or if he met Dylan, or I have no first-hand knowledge of that.
You do have first-hand knowledge, though, sir, as you testified, do you not, that Mr. Tiller told you that he didn't even know who to contact or who to talk to if he wanted to set up a meeting with
right.
Bob Dylan and
but that's,
Jim Damiano.
But that doesn't... How that fits in, I don't really understand, to be honest with you. I don't see his statement saying to me, Jim wanted him to get tickets, and Tony saying, well, who does he think I am that I can do that?
Well, you're aware, sir, are you not, that...
At that time, I knew nothing of Tony's Tiller position at Sony Records. I knew nothing of his background. I didn't know who he knew at Sony Records. Has no knowledge of that at all.
Sir, you're here today because Mr. Damiano has designated you as a witness
right.
of knowledge.
Right, okay. And I'm still trying to figure out why. And my conversation with Jim the whole time, too, has been the same. I don't understand.
Well, is it fair to say that you're a little annoyed about being involved in this whole thing?
It's an inconvenience.
And,
annoyed? I wouldn't say I'm annoyed. Like I just stated, I really don't understand what significant role I have in this.
Okay, well, let's go on and... We'll ask a few more questions, and then
okay.
hopefully we can end the inconvenience for you. You said you met Mikey Harris through her son, Duke.
No, I met Mikey Harris first at Tony Tiller's house at a party. That's when I met Mikey Harris.
And at the time you met...
Like I just stated, I really, really don't understand what significant role I have in this.
Okay, well, let's go on, and we'll ask... You said you met Mikey Harris through her son, Duke.
No, I met Mikey Harris first at Tony Tiller's house at a party. That's when I met Mikey Harris.
And at the time you met her, did you talk about James Damiano's music?
No.
Did you talk about Bob Dylan?
No.
No,
we talked about Irene Conrad and the House of Music and different people that we knew.
So Mr. Damiano's claims and music were simply not discussed when you met Mikey Harris?
No. I didn't even know Jim knew Mikey.
And what's been previously marked as Defendant's Exhibit 6, and that's a copy of 11 Years, and ask you whether that appears to be the document that Mr. Damiano gave you when you met with him in 1994.
Yeah, it looks like it. I don't think it was as thick. It's about that thick.
So perhaps it was a work in progress when he gave it to you.
Yes, part.
Is that the song?
actually, Mikey, we were at the party at Tony's house, and Mikey, we started talking, and ended up, she knew a lot of people that I knew through the studio and stuff. You know, then I ended up, I didn't even know that Duke was her son until we were at a gig, and she was there, and then I definitely made that connection there.
Okay, so last year, Mr. Damiano asked you to accompany him to a...
He had no contact. Mr. Dillon had
nothing to say. As a matter of fact, our relationship, my relationship with Tony had nothing to do with Jim. So when Jim was, we would, you know, talk about Jim or whatever, if Jim came up, like, I really, there was nothing to say because I didn't know Jim. You know, I knew him from the studio, meeting him a couple times, and Phil, you know, working on a lot of sessions with him and stuff.
So do you
that was kind of like, you know, that was the end of that. He wasn't in the studio that much to really say, I don't really know Dylan's style either. It's just that you would, it was just an association where, you know, Bob Dylan, Jim, you know, was just this association that came across.
I'm trying to understand, sir, how you came to associate Mr. Damiano with Bob Dylan.
What the case for that people was. Talking about it, you know, talking with Phil about the sessions and stuff.
And Phil telling you that Jim...
Where, you know, Bob Dylan, Jim, you know, was just this...
Well, I'm trying to...
Association that came across.
I'm trying to understand, sir, how you came to associate Mr. Damiano with Bob Dylan. What the case for that
people was. People talking about it, you know, talking with Phil about the sessions and stuff.